This game is brought to you by Piatt's Bakery in Perrysburg.
Well, the good sports are on WSPD.
The game of the week.
Bob Gigma Jesus through the goalposts of life. End over end, neither left nor to right. Straight through the heart of them righteous upright.
Thank you very much, Skip, and good evening, football fans from Lake High School out on the east side of Toledo. We welcome you to tonight's game between the Lake Flyers and the Jackets, or Yellow Jackets of Perrysburg. What a great night it is for football, Tom Gatto. Gee, it's just super. The sky is almost crystal clear. The band is down below performing, and the crowd is continuing to come in. The field is dry, and you couldn't ask for a better night for an old ball game.
Jerry, I think the frost will be on the pumpkin tonight, and that's football weather. This is the first evening we've had in recent weeks that kind of is typical of football weather in northwestern Ohio. Seeing two fine teams pitted against each other this evening in Lake High School and Perrysburg. Perrysburg comes into the game undefeated. Lake High School suffering one loss to Anthony Wayne last week. Perrysburg defeated Eastwood, Genoa, Sylvania Northview, and Springfield so far this year. Whereas Lake defeated Eastwood, Woodmore, and Genoa, and again, as I mentioned, lost to Anthony Wayne last week. Injuries will play a big role this evening. Out for Perrysburg is their fine guard, middle guard, Jim Jacoby, with a back injury. Doubtful at game time is Mark Patton, the fine tailback for the Lake Flyers. Also suffering a very serious injury was Wes Scott with a cracked fibula, the fullback for Lake. He'll be out for the game. Randy Karras and Todd Robson might be hampered by injuries this evening. Lake won the toss, elected to receive. Perrysburg will kick off and defend the south goal. We'll give you the starting lineups after we throw it back to Jerry.
Well, I just caught it. We thank you very much, Tom. We've got a football up here throwing it around in the press box. And Ed Burns, we appreciate that interesting bit of musical.
I like that. I've got my boots on.
There you go. We got that leading into the game tonight as one just lands over at Mudcap across the way. We'll be back and have more on this football game right after these messages.
No matter what your shopping problem, your Kazmaier Markets are eager to help you, eager to show you how very much they appreciate your loyalty and friendship by making a visit with Kazmaier's a completely happy one. That's why the Kazmaier stock clerks are on the go every minute. They keep a watchful eye rushing in new supplies to guarantee well-filled shelves. Kazmaier personnel are never too busy to stop and help you find what you want and to give suggestions on thrifty, wonderful specials. But the most important job at Kazmaier's is to please you. That's Kazmaier's, your five-star food center in Perrysburg and Wallbridge.
I lead a busy life. I work and have a family to keep up with, so I don't have a lot of time to worry about my wardrobe. I need practical, stylish clothes that reflect my lifestyle but don't break my budget. So I shop at the Fashion Closet in Perrysburg. They have just what I need. Fashions from Northern Isle, Skier, and Pure Gold. And the prices are great. I can afford to keep my wardrobe current. So if you're looking for clothes to reflect your lifestyle, shop the Fashion Closet in downtown Perrysburg. The Fashion Closet for the active woman.
Jerry, starting for the Lake Flyers on offense. At split end, number 10, Chris Abbey, a senior. At left tackle, 72, Dave Passy, a senior. At left guard, 62, Mike Baker, a sophomore. At center, number 50, Steve Horniak, a junior. At right guard and co-captain, number 74, Gus Cannon, a senior. The right tackle is number 75, Larry Nicely, a senior. At tight end, number 84, Dale West, a senior. At quarterback, number 9, Benji Wagner, a senior. And again, doubtful at starting at tailback is Mark Patton, who is a fine junior. I am told if he does not start at tailback, number 7, Rick Ackenberger, will move to tailback. He's a junior. Or we might see number 33, Jeff Shoup, a junior, at tailback.
Also, we'll see Hackenberger at fullback, possibly along with Chris Abbey moving to fullback. At the flank of back, two people might see action there, Chris Abbey and number 21, Tom McDaniels, a junior. And we'll be seeing Lake run out of the tee, out of the eye with two tight ends, and we'll probably see twins tonight. Perrysburg using their standard five-man front. We'll see at the wide side end, number 81, Jay Sweet, who's also co-captain and a senior, at left tackle. Number 61, Jay Sweet, a senior. At middle guard, number 22, Steve Thornton, a senior. At right tackle, number 51, Don Whitner, a senior. The short side end is number 84, Stan Dennis, also a senior. At the inside linebackers, number 73, Tom Carroll, a junior. Number 77, Andy Hufford, a senior. At the monster or stinger back, number 26, Greg Gominger, a senior. The wide side halfback, number 10, Dave Stanford, a junior. The free safety is number 25, Barry Johnston, a senior. And the short side halfback is number 12, Joe Calabrese, a senior.
We'll get back here to Lake High School with more on this one tonight. But again, let's take time out and a word from our sponsors.
Beautiful bathrooms begin at the Color Bathhouse in Perrysburg. Color, you know, they're the leaders in quality and design. Stop out at the Color Bathhouse and see a complete selection of color bath fixtures, tubs, everything for the bath, including exciting whirlpool baths and spas. You'll find the styles you're looking for at the Color Bathhouse showroom, serving all of Northwest Ohio and Southeast Michigan. Plan your beautiful bathroom at the Color Bathhouse, 125 East Indiana in Perrysburg. Since 1933, Lorraine Oil has been helping you and me live better lives by distributing the petroleum products we need to run our cars, homes, businesses, and farms. Lorraine Oil represents the Sun Oil Company, Pennzoil, and Quaker State, and their fleet of trucks and tankers guarantee prompt delivery. Discuss your petroleum needs with Lorraine Oil President Mr. Bernie Schneider. Call Lorraine Oil at 691-3545 or 352-1633.
The officials for this Northern Lakes League Conference battle. The referee is Dick Nowak, the umpire Joe Barna, the linesman is Dave Nowak, and the field judge is Scott Shook. Sounds a little bit like a law firm. Nowak, Barna, Nowak, and Shook.
I like it, Tom. You may be hot tonight. You may be.
I hope
you,
I'm
you
warm.
May be, yeah, well, well, you may be rolling tonight. You may be rolling. Tom, the field's in great shape. You just couldn't ask for a more perfect setting for this very big confrontation between the Lake Flyers and the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets. As Tom said, the Jackets are 4-0 in the Northern Lakes League, and the Flyers have just game back. And of course, they've got Perrysburg on their home field here tonight. Lake High School has, so across the way, the Perrysburg Yellow Jacket fans, and we are on the eastern side of the field, or the lake side. Stands are filled.
Remember last year, Jerry, Lake came into Perrysburg with a similar situation injury-wise. Their quarterback, Benji Wagner, was out. Their second-team quarterback got hurt in the first quarter, and they wound up finishing up the game with their third-team quarterback. So Lake has had their injury problems over the last couple of years, but Jim Smith and his staff have done a things together, and I'm really anticipating a hard-hitting contest, and Perrysburg, as everyone felt, is on a roll, and we'll see if they can continue that here in the NLL.
As I look down to my immediate left, the Lake Flyers are getting set to come on the field, and so we'll be back with tonight's opening kickoff in just a moment.
You're only a coin away from brighter, fresher, cleaner laundry and dry cleaning when you visit Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, 3600 Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. At Walnut Hills, they feature coin-operated laundry and dry cleaning equipment with an attendant on duty at all times. And there's always ample parking at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning. Open from 7:30 a.m. to 9 p.m. for your convenience. Just put your coins in and watch the clean come through at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. Racquetball. The Racket Connection in Perrysburg offers you all this. 12 racquetball courts, plus indoor tennis courts, a heated indoor pool, exercise equipment, lounge areas, saunas, and whirlpools, a pro shop, nursery, and a family Nautilus center. The Racket Connection in Perrysburg. Play racquetball, tennis, and swim all year round. Join now for fall and winter fun. The Racket Connection, 874-4318. 874-4318. Near the Holiday Inn in Perrysburg.
On the league starting lineup being introduced to the crowd tonight, they'll be in the blue jerseys with the white pants, the white numerals, the blue helmets, and the Perrysburg yellow jackets across the way in their gold pants, the gold helmets, and the white jerseys with the black numerals. Very easy to see. Now, when we go over to Perrysburg, they've got those almost like the Army Knights with that black jersey and those gold numerals, kind of tough to pick up. But tonight, we shouldn't have too much problem. That is, if I can see this evening.
Well, as you mentioned, the field is in fine shape, no problem with mud. And Lake always does a fine job with their field, as does Perrysburg. And again, we have to say that the Northern Lakes League people do an outstanding job with their athletic facilities.
Reminding you, this is WSBD Toledo 1370 on your dial, your station for sports tomorrow night, Toledo at Eastern Michigan. Broadcast time at 6:55 with kickoff at 7:30 from the Glass Bowl. We hope to see you there. The Rockets need one. Eastern is 1-1 in the Mid-America Conference, Toledo 0-1, and we'd like to see it filled and rocking tomorrow night. Lost another player. Brady is out for a couple of weeks with the cracked ribs suffered Wednesday in practice time. At least it wasn't Thursday. Most of the players went down on Thursday. A black Thursday.
Again, you're always the bearer of bad tidings. Deep for Lake will be Ackenberger, Wagner, and Shoup to receive this kickoff.
All right, Ackenberger is on the, well, he's in the middle now. Shoup on the far side, and here on the near side of the eastern side is Wagner. And old number 78, teeing the ball up for the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets, Bill Shoup, S-H-O-O-F. Squared up, and here we go. Kickoff, bouncer, hits up short, fielded there like a second baseman at the 25, at the 30, and hit and brought down right there. Right around the 35-yard line, and running that kickoff back, the Lake Flyers, and a pretty good job, I would say, by the young man, by fielding that like a second baseman on a short hop. He was nailed good at the 35, and it's first down and 10 yards to go now for the Flyers. Benji Wagner will be that quarterback. We'll check that backfield for you as we go along. There might be a change or two in here tonight because of injuries. Lining up is Ackenberger at the fullback at number 33.
Now, Patton's starting at a wing.
Patton is starting at a wing then.
Nope.
And there's a handoff over the right side of Ackenberger, the 35, at the 40, the 45, the 50, the 45, the 40, the 35, the 20, the 15, the 10, and down he goes at the 5-yard line and a quick trap over the right side. Finally brought down at the 5-yard line by Greg Gominger. A brilliant run on the first play from scrimmage.
Sure, that was an outstanding run. And the right side of that Lake line, Gus Cannon nicely, Dale West, and also the split end over there, Chris Abbey, did an outstanding job opening up that hole. And I was incorrect, Jerry. Mark Patton is not in the backfield.
That was Shoup back there at tailback, and Ackenberger got the call at fullback. Here's the I formation. Shoup at tailback. Ackenberger is your fullback. Wagner calling signals at the 5, first and goal. Quarterback keeper, and he's down back at the 7-yard line. Wagner nowhere to go. The left side of that Perrysburg line in on the tackle. And the first man to get him there for the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets then was Andy Hufford. A tackle, 211 pounds. It is second and goal for the Lake Flyers at the 7-yard line as they move right to left across your dial here at Lake High School. Jerry Kyle, Tom Gatto, nice to have you along. Out over the ball is Ponyak. We have twin flankers out wide to the left. High in the backfield, Ackenberger is the quarterback, or fullback, pardon me. Back to throw is Wagner. He's in trouble, and he's going to be sacked all the way back to the 25-yard line. And getting in there is Steve Thornton.
Big play for the sack.
Wow.
Big play by the Perrysburg middle guard, Jerry. He stepped around the center, and that could be not only a key play in this drive, but a key play in this ball game.
Well, they sent twin flankers out wide to the left that time. Chris Abbey was out there, one of those wide receivers. And now out wide to the right for the Flyers. Is Abby? It is third down and 24 yards to go. They cannot pick up a first down. A hand in there to Hackenberger. And Hackenberger is across the 25 and down to about the 21. And he's wrapped up right there. Tom Carroll on the tackle for Perrysburg. It'll be fourth down and goal to go at the Perrysburg 21. Remember that great opening play on a quick trap over the right side to Hackenberger. He got down to the 5-yard line. First and goal. It's back at the 21 now where it's fourth down and goal. And they're going to go for it here. Twin flankers out wide to the right. Chris Abbey is out there. I don't know who number six is, Tom. We got to pick him up.
That's McDaniels.
McDaniels. All right. Back to throw the football. Wagner into the end zone. It goes and it's overthrown by 5 yards. And Perrysburg has done the job. They have held the Lake Flyers.
Now they changed jerseys with Tom McDaniels, a junior halfback. He was supposed to wear number 21. He's wearing number 6.
All right,
but in any event, Perrysburg will take over on their own 21-yard line.
Well, that's a great job by Perrysburg after Lake had had it first and goal at the 5. It is now first and 10 for Perrysburg at their own 21. Heilman's the quarterback, and they'll line up on a power eye. A power eye formation, and a hand to the halfback over the left side. He got it out to the 25-yard line, and that's it. We've got Gominger in there, along with Heckland and Priest. And the right side of that Lake line in on the tackle. They gang tackled him good that time, Tom. Nicely was in there. All right.
Up front for Perrysburg is Andy Hufford, Steve Morgan, Don Whitner, Jim King, Jim Wolf, Stan Dennis.
Second down and sixth at the 25 of Perrysburg. Heilman, the quarterback, they're in the power eye. And again, he gives to Gominger over the left side. And he is hit and hit hard right there at the 25-yard line. Gang tackling there, and a good job done by Larry Nicely once again. The first man to get him. So it'll bring up a third down and still six for the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets at their own 25-yard line. There's no score with 8:37 remaining here in the first quarter.
Perrysburg has Barry Johnson at a wingback and Michael Ajeski at a split end.
Terrain out wide to the right. Heilman splits his setbacks now on a third and six, and he's back to throw the football. Looking sideline left, he fires it over the middle, and it's incomplete. Little slant-in pattern there that was intended for number 25, Barry Johnston. He had it for a moment and then dropped it. Up at the 35-yard line, that would have been a first down. That'll bring up fourth down and 6 yards to go for Perrysburg, a punting situation. And back deep will go Rick Hackenberger. Wagner also dropping back deep. And here is the punt coming up from the 12-yard line. The snap is good, and he gets the kick away. Pretty good kick out of there. Cross field, Wagner makes the reception, and he's going to run the football at the 40 to the 42-yard line, and that is it. First man down to trip him up was Gominger, slowed him down, and then the tackle was secured by Tom Carroll. It'll be first down and 10 yards to go now for Lake, starting at their own 42.
About a 30-yard punt by Jay Swede, Jerry.
There's no score in this football game with 8 minutes remaining in the first quarter. And now the Flyers take over again for their second possession at their own 42-yard line. Wagner is the quarterback. Your fullback is Hackenberger, and Shoup is the tailback. Open field is to the left of the eastern side. Pitch back to Shoup at the 35. Spins inside, hit and down right there. And a great hit put on by Jay Swede. He had him back there at the 36, but they're going to give him his penetration out to the 39. So there's a loss on the play from the 42 back to the 39 of 3 yards. It'll be second down and about 13.
We got the Swede connection on that left side, Jerry. Jay at the wide side end and Jace at left tackle.
They move out of it now and will send twin flankers. Well, Abby out here to the left. And he is joined by Bitter. Back to throw the football is Wagner rolling out, looking sideline, over the middle it goes, man open, it's complete and then dropped. He had it and then he dropped it when he took the hit from behind.
Big hit by Johnson.
And he didn't have it long enough, Tom, did not have possession of the football. He had it and then dropped it as he took the cruncher from the blind side. Good hit, popped the ball loose.
Good job by Benji Wagner sprinting out to his left. He's a right-handed thrower and fired a strike.
But good defensive play brings it back.
They're down, still about 13 to go. And again, out wide to the left is Abbey. Now Wagner splits his setbacks. Wagner calling signals, and he's back to throw or run the football at the 30. He may run at the 35, cuts inside of the 40, and hit end down at the 45-yard line on a fine open field tackle by Greg Gumminger. However, they'll spot the ball at the 45-yard line, and that will be about 6 yards short of that first down. It's just over the lake. 45, call it the 46 on the eastern hash mark in a punting situation here. No score, 6:45 to go, first quarter. An electrifying opening run by Ackenberger got him to the 5 where it was first and goal, but it ended up back on the 21-yard line.
Wagner will be punting to Johnson and Gumminger.
Wagner at his own 32, waiting for the snap, gets a good snap. The return is on, and he gets an end-over-ender away. A fair catch is called for, and it's received and now right there at the 25. And for just a moment, Barry Johnston had a second thought. He may have wanted to run that football. It was not much hang time, and it was kind of an end-over-runner, line-drive type effect, and he could have had some running room.
Another 30-yard punt, Jerry.
First and 10, then, for the Jackets. They'll start this time from their own 25, their first possession at the 21. Out wide to the right is Mike Ojeski. Your quarterback is Heilman. He's got him in the I formation. And on the power sweep around the right side of the 26, 7, 8-yard line, Gumminger, the ball carrier, knocked down by the left side of that Lake Flyer line. And the first man there to get him was Emmett Reyes. And so let's pop the ball from the 25 out to the 29. Give him about 4, second and 6. 6 minutes remaining, first quarter, no score.
All the 29-yard line of the Yellow Jackets.
And again, Johnston split out wide to the right, eye in the backfield, open field is to the left of the eastern side. Heilman sticks it into his fullback and nowhere to go. And I'll tell you why, because old number 75, Larry Nicely, was right there to meet the rush by the fullback, Troy Heckland, and nothing going. Bring up third down and still about 6 to go. At the, well, he might have gotten a half a yard. Let's still call it the 29.
Lake is using a split-six defense, Jerry. 4 down linemen and 4 home linebackers.
Now Johnston to the left side. Eye in the backfield, and they're up tight, I'll tell you. Right behind the quarterback, a fake in there. He's going to run the football high. A towel comes flying out of there, but he is hit and brought down, and again in on the tackle was number 55, and that is Emmett Reyes.
Reyes is at an end nicely, a left tackle, number 62. Mike Baker is right tackle, and number 84, Dale West, is a right end. The inside linebackers, Horniak and Cannon. The outside backers, Robson and Abbey.
Back to punt time.
Jay Sweet.
On the near side is Ackenberger. On the far side is Wagner. The snap, the kick is away. Again, a low kick. It's the 40, 35, 30, 25, 24, and down at the 23-yard line. He got the roll that time.
23-yard line. Fires take over first and pass.
Perrysburg won the battle of the punts in that exchange, Jerry. Lake starts off with their poorest field position to get a series going.
We have 4.5 minutes remaining in the quarter, and there's no score at Lake High School. Great crowd on hand here tonight. Nice to have you along. Wagner's the quarterback, and he has him lined up in the I formation. Ackenberger and Shue. And he gives to Ackenberger over the right side to the 25, to the 26, maybe the 27-yard line. That'll be it. Stan Dennis on the tackle. Give him the 27-yard line. So from the 23 to the 27, a gain of about 4. It'll be second and 6. Second and just about 6. Clock continues to run. 3:58 to go first quarter. There's no score. The ball is on the western hash mark. Now out wide to the left is McDaniels. And Wagner splits his setbacks. And he... his hands in there. Good job of faking to Ackenberger, but Perrysburg was not faked out. And the first man to get him right around the line of scrimmage was Jay Sweet. As a matter of fact, he got it right back to about the line of scrimmage. 26-yard line where it's third and still about 6.5 to go. Long 6. And end, it's turning into one of those slug-em-out affairs, Thomas. Twin flankers out wide to the right now, Abbey and McDaniels. High formation in the backfield. And a pitch back. The ship trying to get outside, and no, sir. Dropped down at the 24-yard line.
I'll tell you, Jay Swede, the left tackle, just shot a gap, Jerry. Read the play very well. Brought him down for a loss. Lake Flyers are going to have to shore up that offensive front if they're going to be able to move the ball against this fine Perrysburg defense.
Well, that's fourth down and about eight. Wagner's going to kick her. Johnston is back, along with Gominger. And Wagner standing back on his 12-yard line. Gets a good snap. The block is on, and they almost got it. We're going to get roughing the kicker. We're going to get a flag on this one. Couldn't control his body, the young man. We've got two flags coming out now, and it's down by Lake up here at the 48-yard line of Perrysburg, but the flag dropped immediately as the young man could not control his body. We've got a flag back at the 13. We've got one up here at the 24. Illegal procedure, Lake, roughing the kicker, Perrysburg, offsetting penalties. How about that? Holy Lake. Well, Lake would have had a big penalty in their favor, but they
would have had a first
illegal
down.
Procedure. Yeah.
The procedure penalty is the fact that one of the inside linemen released before the ball was kicked. In defense of the young man guilty of the roughing the kicker, it looked like he was going to go for the ball, and then the punter moved, and he hit the kicker.
Wagner back to kick.
Well, Wagner back to do it all over again now, standing again back at about, well, his 11-yard line this time. Johnston and Gominger, good snap. The return is on this time, and he gets a good high kick out of there. Johnston back at his 45 and down at the 43-yard line, and great downfield tackle that time. Well, that was just a super job by Dale West. First and 10 for Perrysburg as the two teams slug it out here at Will Lake High School, trying to maneuver for field position. And right now, Perrysburg is inching up to start a series closer and closer to that 50-yard line. It's up to 43 right now. Heilman's your quarterback. And out wide to the right is Johnston. He's got split backs in there right now. Gominger. And Gominger gets the call at the 45, into the 50, to the 45, and one man to beat, and he was long gone, down to the 42-yard line. Little trap over the right side, the short side of the field, and making the tackle was Wagner, along with Emmett Reyes again. However,
if Benji Wagner doesn't get an arm on him, Gominger is all the way for a touch.
There's no question about that. Heilman has them huddled back here at the 50, and they break out of it right now. They line up in the power eye. That's Gominger, Heckman, and Priest. Open field is to the western side, and the ball on the counterplay over the right side, and spinning in there is number 25 for Perrysburg. That's Johnston, but he got very little yardage to about the 41, so give him a yard. It'll be second and 9.
Running out of the power eye with the wing back as a setback, Jerry. They're trying to run counter trap, and Lake will have none of it.
Michael Jeske out wide to the left, and out wide to the right is Johnston, now an eye in the backfield. Back to throw the football is Heilman, looking deep down the left sideline. Man is there, and it's he had it, dropped it at the 12-yard line. He had it, and he dropped it. Good effort by Michael Jeske. Very catchable. Probably should have made the reception.
Mark Michael Jeske, Jerry, ran an out and up. The ball was not thrown very high, and he did have to battle a Lake defender and probably distracted him somewhat.
Well, that'll bring up a third and 9 at the Lake 41. And now out wide to the left this time goes Kip Terrain. Again, eye in the backfield. And rolling to his left, a pitch back, and turning the corner is Gominger straight ahead at the 40 and to about the 41, maybe the 40-yard line. Let's see where his knee went down. I'm going to call it the 37-yard line. He was tripped up there by the right side of that Lake line. First man there was Dan Kennan. That'll bring out, however, a fourth down and just about 5 yards to go. It's at the 37 of Lake. But, of course,
More and more, Perrysburg is getting better and better field position, Tom.
Now, it's the kicking game is really coming into play.
That's going to end the quarter. That is the end of the first quarter with a score. Perrysburg nothing, Lake nothing. We'll be back in a moment.
Add to the success of your next party with a lavishly prepared party tray from Zenko's Old World Deli in Perry's Landing. Zenko's features a complete selection of delicious deli meats and imported cheeses. And they'll prepare a party tray for 10 or more. You'll appreciate the time it saves and the glamour that it gives to your party. Call Zenko's at 874-1401 or stop in for lunch or dinner. Zenko's makes the greatest deli sandwiches. Zenko's Old World Deli.
In downtown Perrysburg, the fashion closet for the active woman.
We've got one of those defensive struggles going on right now. All right, Sweet is back to kick now at the 50. Gets a good snap, and he gets a high one, trying to hang it inside that 10-yard line. It goes out of bounds in the neighborhood of the 17 or 18-yard line.
Well, I'd like to, Jerry, I could make a living betting on that in high school and college. Anytime a punter tries to get fancy and drill it into the coffin corner, invariably they shank one, and if they just try to kick it in the end zone, they might have more success.
All right, now Lake will take over at their own 18-yard line. There's no score on the game, and we're in the second over at their own 18-yard line. There's no score on the game, and we're in the second quarter of play. The quarterback is Wagner. He's gone all the way. We've got a new tailback in there, Tom, number 42. Let's check him out. Eckenberger still, and the hand goes to the tailback, number 40. And that is Mac Patton for Lake, and he got it out to the 20-yard line, and that's it. It'll be second down at 8 yards to go. And I want to wait until they unpile the last man to get up for Perrysburg, number 73, Tom Carroll. So it'll be second down, about 8 to go.
Mark Patton's coming off, Jerry. That back injury might be a little bit more severe than he had thought.
Wagner, Eckenberger, Shoop in that backfield. Patton in for a play, but he's out right away. All right, so Shoop is back in. And he's in the backfield at split back with Eckenberger. We have a wide out to the left and a hand over the right side, and running the ball is Shoop. He got it to the original line of scrimmage, the 18-yard line. That's it. Thank you. And again, we'll wait until they unpile, and the very last man to get up there for Perrysburg High School, Don Whitner. And so let's call it third down and about 9.5 yards to go.
Jerry, Lake trying the old scissors trap. Don Whitner was the trapee, and he refused to be trapped.
Abbey split out here to the right of the eastern side, and Wagner will split his setbacks, and he's back to throw the football, rolling out to the sideline, looking over the middle, it goes incomplete. He had it and he dropped it, he being Abbey. Well, there's been some drop balls out here so far in this first half, Tom.
Well, it certainly has nothing to do with the climate. It's good due to some fine hitting on the part of the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets.
And here we go again with another punting situation with 10:33 remaining in the first half. No score. Wagner back deep at about his 6. Johnson back here, the deep man.
Block is on.
Gominger, the block is on, and he just got it away. Coming up, Johnston at the 40. Oh, what a hit. What a hit. At about the 40-yard line, and he got it ahead, Johnston did, to about the 39. Did you see who got the hit on that one, Tom?
I don't know, Jerry. There's a host of Lake tacklers, but boy, I think Coach Chuck Pratt ought to take Johnson aside. That was awful dangerous the way he ran up after that football.
That's the 39-yard line. Heilman lines him up. Man in motion to the left now. That's Johnston. First we've seen that. And he pitches back into Gominger. Cuts inside at the 40, at the 35, straight ahead and down at about the 32. About the 32-yard line. Getting up. He is nicely. He made the initial hit. So there's a pretty good pickup on the play.
This is the... Go ahead, Jerry.
6 yards, second down, about 4 to go.
The advantage of having a seasoned veteran backfield with Gominger, who's been running at tailback for 3 years, was evident there as he cut back against the grain.
All right, again, Johnston in motion to the right. And a pitchback and trying to get outside with the football. Running hard is Gominger, and he is nailed by
fine defensive play that time by Rias. Right about the line of scrimmage there at the 32 and a half yard line. It's third down, still about four, short four. Perrysburg moving right to left on your dial, and there's no score with 9:15 to go in the first half.
Rias and Nicely have been doing an outstanding job on their side of the line of scrimmage.
Let's see what the Jackets do this time. They'll send Johnson out wide to the right, and they'll form the eye in the backfield. The fullback is Heckland, and Gomager at tailback. Hyama options down the line, cuts inside at the 30, at the 25, to the 20, and runs over a man and out of bounds inside the 20-yard line, way across the far side of the field. And putting the pressure on over there was Honyak. However, when they bring it in from the far sidelines, they'll say right around the 21-yard line.
Jerry, fine read by Jim Heilman, the quarterback. First time where he has kept the ball on the option. The option was taken away by the Lake perimeter. He ducked it inside and picked up the first down.
Johnson out wide to the right. Let's call it the 21 of Lake. Eye on the backfield. Heilman's your quarterback. And option play, same play. Cuts outside and down. Still running with a lot of force and balance as he put the arm down in hand. But his knee went down, I believe, back here at the 20-yard line. Well, Hammond did a great job that time as he braced himself with his arm and his hand. And I thought for a moment he might get five more, but they say no. He's down right there, kind of under his own power at the 20-yard line. A gain of about a yard. It'll be second and nine. 8:18 to go first half, no score. Out wide to the left is Michael Jeske. We have a wing left of the backfield. Johnston is the wingman. Heilman calling signals. Johnson in motion to the right. Heilman pitches back to Gomager at the 25, at the 20, and he's gang tackled right there at the 20-yard line. Great hit in there by Andy Hufford. First man to get him. And that'll bring up a third and still about 90. Titanic defensive struggle going on out here right now after that electrifying opening run by Rick Hackenberger down to the five. But Lake could not get it in. They ended up, as a matter of fact, back at the 21. Timeout coming up here.
Randy Karras, fine tackle for Lake, is injured, Jerry.
All right, so this may be a shorty, eh? Yeah. Timeout on the field with the score, Lake nothing, Perrysburg nothing. Be back in a moment.
Since 1933, Lorraine Oil has been helping you and me live better lives by distributing the petroleum products we need to run our cars, homes, businesses, and farms. Lorraine Oil represents the Sun Oil Company, Pennzoil, and Quaker State, and their fleet of trucks and tankers guarantee prompt delivery. Discuss your petroleum needs with Lorraine Oil President Mr. Bernie Schneider. Call Lorraine Oil at 691-3545 or 352-1633.
All right, that was a quick timeout for the injury. We've got a third down, a power eye in the backfield now. Man in motion is Johnston to the right. Open field is to the left, the eastern side. A fake and a back and a peel back here. Oh, the old end around, a wing around, and they did. Well, he gets away from one man, Johnson, back here at the 30. Cuts around, he gets away from another man, and still fights his way ahead and finally down at the 25-yard line. That brought the crowd to their feet for a moment. Well, Lake was not fooled, I'll tell you that.
Well scouted by the Lake coaching staff.
Mike Baker on the tackle, excuse me.
Mr. Johnson had no chance to make any kind of yardage.
Going
to
go for three here. Bill Schoof, S-C-H-O-O-F. Now a timeout. Full timeout. Timeout on the field with a score. Lake nothing, Perrysburg nothing.
What a happy experience good eating can be. Actually, many happy ways when you enjoy the wonderfully fresh produce from your Kazmaier markets. Just see for yourself the bloom on the fruit and the crispness of Kazmaier vegetables. See the rich glow of color that promises ripe flavor. Check the fragrance and plump firmness that says fresh picked. And above all, savor their delicious fresh flavor. Mmm, good. That's good eating. And all this freshness, top quality, and abundant choice are yours at true budget prices from Kazmaier markets in Perrysburg. Bergen Walbridge, Kazmaier's, your five-star food center.
Racquetball.
The Racket Connection in Perrysburg offers you all this. 12 racquetball courts, plus indoor tennis courts, a heated indoor pool, exercise equipment, lounge areas, saunas and whirlpools, a pro shop, nursery, and a family Nautilus center. The Racket Connection in Perrysburg. Play racquetball, tennis, and swim all year round. Join now for fall and winter fun. The Racket Connection, 874-4318. 874-4318. Near the Holiday Inn in Perrysburg.
Here's the 42-yard try now. Holding for the Jackets will be Calabrese. It's a straight-up shot, Thomas. Straight-up shot. Shoot. No, it's a fake. The bomb. It's in the air. It is completed. The 5-4-3 touchdown to Michael Jeske. They faked the field goal and back to throw.
We have a flag,
Mr.
Jerry.
Calabrese, and this may be brought back. Oh, my goodness. What was it, Tom?
Looked like a clip.
A clip? Well thrown by Calabrese. He's a quarterback. You know, I had a feeling, Tom. I was going to say it. Probably should have, but watch out for the fake. That would have been a...
Now, let's hold up on that call, right, Jerry. Dick Nowak gave me one, and then one signal, and gave me another one.
I see.
Looked like Earl Weaver out there.
Mm-hmm. The walk-off is against Perrysburg, and it's a big one. Out to the 40-yard line, and what, illegal receiver downfield?
I don't understand.
Well, that really, really hurts what appeared to be a touchdown to the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets. However, they still have possession of the football. It's fourth down now, and a long way to go, 29 yards. Swede is back to punt. We're going to have a timeout here, are we? Yes, we are. There's a timeout on the field with a score Lake nothing, Perrysburg nothing.
Beautiful bathrooms begin at the Color Bathhouse in Perrysburg. Color. You know, they're the leaders in quality and design. Stop out at the Color Bathhouse and see a complete selection of Color bath fixtures, tubs, everything for the bath, including exciting whirlpool baths and spas. You'll find the styles you're looking for at the Color Bathhouse showroom, serving all of Northwest Ohio and Southeast Michigan. Plan your beautiful bathroom at the Color Bathhouse, 125 East Indiana in Perrysburg. Zenko's Old World Deli in Perry's Landing makes a unique variety of sandwiches. Sandwiches that are stacked high with deli meats and cheeses and other good things. The way you would stack them on a midnight raid to the icebox. And no one can top Zenko's grinders and party subs. When you're hungry for a real deli sandwich, you have to go to a real deli. And that's Zenko's. Eat there in the great atmosphere or carry out. Zenko's, Perry's Landing, Perrysburg, open Monday through Saturday, 10 to 7.
Discussion going on down. Lake called that timeout, Mr. Coteau.
I don't think we'll see a fake punt here, Jerry, but I think possibly Lake wanted to make sure that everyone was squared away from this point on all fourth down situations, either field goals or punts of the fake variety.
Swede is back to punt now at his own 46, 6:35 to go on the half, no score. Single safety, Wagner, snap, gets the kick away. High one, floater, 15, rolls laterally, and dead at the 16-yard line, first and 10 for Lake.
Well, both defenses have risen to the occasion, Jerry. Perrysburg stopped Lake after a first and goal on the 5, and Lake came through, and Perrysburg took over on the Lake 39-yard line after a short punt.
Lake back to work now. They'll move from their own 16-yard line, left to right on your dial, and they'll be moving south to north. We're on the eastern side
with 6:11 left in the first half.
Twins out wide to the right. McDaniels along with Abby. Your quarterback is Heilman. He's back to throw the field. He's in trouble. Wagner going to scramble, and he gets away from him. One man, but not another. Well, Wagner got away from one man, but he didn't get away from number 22, I believe it is, and that is
Steve Thornton, the middle guard. That time, Jerry, Perrysburg jumped into a six-man line. They dropped the linebacker down into a gap,
And they were really coming, putting the pressure on Benji Wagner.
Lost about three, back inside that 15, so it's second down and about 13 to go. Lake at their own 13. Now Abbey out wide to the right, and the ends are in. It's an eye in the backfield. Wagner, Eckenberger, and Shoup. Wagner straight ahead, running hard. The fullback, Eckenberger, out over the 20 to the 23 or 4-yard line. Carroll is there on the tackle for the Jackets. Pretty good gainer. Third down, however, and about three. With 5 minutes remaining in the first half, there's no score. It's at the 24-yard line of Lake. In with a play for the Flyers. Greg Stute. S-T-O-U-T. Abbey out wide to the right. And Wagner leads him up. Eckenberger in there at fullback, and he sticks it in there. Wagner does to Eckenberger across the 25 to about the 26-yard line. And again, Thornton on the tackle. That'll be a little short of that first down, I believe. It's going to be close, but I think it's going to be fourth and inches. We'll see. They're going to bring the chains in.
Well, Jerry, jumping into the six-man front again, Perrysburg shot the gaps. One gap man went right by the fullback. Well, I don't believe he's made it.
I think he's short by a couple inches. Got it. I finally called one right. It's fourth down and about a foot.
I'm now one for three. That was my first one, Jerry.
Uh-huh. Fourth and about a foot to go. We're going to call it the 26-yard line of Lake, and they're going to have to punt it out of there with 4:29 left here in the half. There's no score.
And this is, again, where the kicking game is so all important in the high school ranks, college ranks, as well as the pro ranks.
Wagner,
you've got to be able to get it out of there.
Johnston deep, along with Gominger. They're not so sure, Perrysburg, he's going to punt this football. The return is on. He gets the kick away. Pretty good floater out of there. Fair catch call for him at the 47 and down there by Johnston. It'll be first down and 10 yards to go, Perrysburg, at their own 47-yard line. They have 4 minutes and 3 seconds to do something about the score, which is right now nothing. Don't forget tomorrow night, Toledo and Eastern Michigan, 6:55. Our pregame programming with kickoff at 7:30 from the Glass Bowl. Trotting on the field is Jim Heilman. He'll have Hecklin back there along with Gominger. He'll send Johnston out wide to the right. And out wide to the left, Michael Jeske. Heilman may put it in the air. No, he sticks it right into the first man. Spins Gominger at the 45, at the 50, at 45. He may go. At the 30, at the 25, at the 20, at the 15, at the 10. 5, 4, 3, touchdown.
Boy, an outstanding piece of running, Jerry. Lining up in split backs, as you mentioned. A straight dive over right guard. Looked like Gominger was stopped after a 3-yard gain. He spun away from another tackler, broke into the clear, and outraced all the defenders for a 53-yard touchdown scamper with 3:53 on the clock.
Big play.
He's a fine back, Jerry.
Shoof to try the punt after. Holding will be Calabrese. Waiting for the snap. First score of the night. Ball down. Kick in the air. The kick is good. There's a timeout on the field with a score of Perrysburg 7, Lake nothing.
You're only a coin away from brighter, fresher, cleaner laundry and dry cleaning when you visit Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, 3600 Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. At Walnut Hills, they feature coin-operated laundry and dry cleaning equipment with an attendant on duty at all times. And there's always ample parking at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning. Open from 7:30 a.m. to 9 p.m. for your convenience. Just put your coins in and watch the clean come through at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. People are particular about eggs. That's why Kazmaier's 5-star AA grade eggs are so very popular. Champions for freshness, they are grated and candled and then rushed directly to your Kazmaier market in Perrysburg and in Walbridge. Champions for flavor, the delicate farm fresh taste of AA grade eggs say quality better than any number of words. They're graded AA because they come up to the most exacting specifications. And because they are Kazmaier's very own, these superior eggs are champions for economy at thrifty Kazmaier prices. Naturally, each one is unconditionally guaranteed. Try some soon. That's Kazmaier's, your 5-star food center in Walbridge and Perrysburg.
On the kickoff, Bill Schuf nails it down there to about the 10. Hackenberger right up the middle and gets it out to the 25-yard line where he's belted down. It'll be first and 10 then for the Lake Flyers at their own 25. And now they trail 7-0. McDaniels out wide to the right. Hackenberger along with Schuf in that backfield. Wagner calling signals, pitches back to Schuf at the 20, cuts across the green, fumbles the football, recovered by Perrysburg, and I believe it's number 61, and that would be Jay Sweet. Schuf did not have a good hold on it. Let's see if it's, no, it's number
Don Whitner, Jerry.
All right, Whitner. Number 71. Well, I got half the number right. It'll be first and 10 for the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets now with great field position here at the 25. And Lake's going to call a timeout. Timeout on the field with a score. Perrysburg 7, Lake nothing.
I lead a busy life. I work and have a family to keep up with, so I don't have a lot of time to worry about my wardrobe. I need practical, stylish clothes that reflect my lifestyle but don't break my budget. So I shop at the Fashion Closet in Perrysburg. They have just what I need. Fashions from Northern Isle, Skier, and Pure Gold, and the prices are great. I can afford to keep my wardrobe current. So if you're looking for clothes to reflect your lifestyle, shop the Fashion Closet in downtown Perrysburg. The Fashion Closet for the active woman.
Beautiful bathrooms begin at the Color Bathhouse in Perrysburg. Color, you know, they're the leaders in quality and design. Stop out at the Color Bathhouse and see a complete selection of Color bath fixtures, tubs, everything for the bath, including exciting whirlpool baths and spas. You'll find the styles you're looking for at the Color Bathhouse showroom, serving all of Northwest Ohio and Southeast Michigan. Plan your beautiful bathroom at the Color Bathhouse, 125 East Indiana in Perrysburg.
The Jackets lead 7-0. A great break here. The recovery of the fumble, and now they line up and do what they've bounced to. Not quite a shotgun, but they got them spread out all over. Hyam in the quarterback, and he drops back to throw the football at the 30. He going for the bomb down the far sidelines, and it is incomplete in the end zone. It would have been 6. Johnston dropped the football. Defending on the play was Hackenberger. Bring it back and make it 2nd down and 10 at the 25-yard line, 26-yard line of Lake.
Perrysburg lined up in a pro formation, Jerry. Split backs, Heilman dropped back. Johnson on a fly pattern down this near sideline was wide open in the end zone. The ball just bounced off his fingertips.
They go into a wing left in the backfield now. Johnson is the wingman. Heilman is the quarterback. And he pitches back to Gominger, cuts inside and tripped up. Good job. Good defensive play that time. Abby tripped him up. Back there at about the 26, maybe got to the 25. It's going to be 3rd and still about 10.
Chris Abbey playing outside linebacker, but what really amounts to a monster back in that 4-4 defense. Red sweep and really popped and got a hand on the ball carrier's ankle and prevented a big gain.
Johnston to the right and out wide here to the left is Michael Jeske. Heilman splits his setbacks. With 2.5 remaining in the half, he's back to throw. Setting up, the chase is on. He's in trouble. He's going to be sacked back here at the 32-yard line. And storming in was Karras. And also number 84, that's West. And there's a big loss back outside the 30 at the 32, where it's 4th down and long.
Good coverage by the Lake secondary, Jerry. And had Heilman thrown the ball, Perrysburg would have had another illegal receiver downfield.
4th and 16, 2 minutes remaining in a punting situation, but look out, they may fake it. You got to watch these Perrysburg Yellow Jackets. Wagner is deep, the snap, and the kick is away. And again, he angles for the sideline, and he boots this for the cup in corner inside the 20-yard line and out of bounds the 16-yard line. All right, that keeps Lake back in there tight. It's at the 16 where it's 1st and 10.
After the opening kickoff, Jerry, Lake has really had their backs against the wall, taking over on their 18, their 16, their 25, and now again their 16.
7-0 in favor of Perrysburg, a minute and 51 seconds remaining till halftime. McDaniels out wide to the right. Quarterback is Wagner. Hackenberger is back there at the fullback, along with Schuf. And he gives it in there to Hackenberger straight ahead. He's got a yard, and that's about it. Pretty tough going against the middle of that Perrysburg Yellow Jacket line. Jay Swede, the first man to knock him down. Give him a yard, second and nine. It's at the 17, and the clock continues to roll with a minute and 30 seconds remaining here in the first half. It is 7-0 in favor of Perrysburg.
Again, Perrysburg using a steady diet of that six-man line.
Bitter out wide to the right. And he is joined by Abbey. Splitbacks. Option play, a handoff in there to the fullback, Hackenberger, once again. Got it back to the line of scrimmage, and he was tripped up there by the left side of that Perrysburg line. Swede tripping him up. Also helping out on the play was Whitner. Let's make it third and still about nine to go at the 17 of Lake with 50 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Standing room only at Lake High, 7-0 Perrysburg. Abbey out wide to the right, and the ends are in this time. Eye in the backfield. Wagner's your quarterback. He's moving left to right on your dial. And he hands in there to Gominger over the left side of the dive. Play out to the 19, pardon me, I said Gominger, Hackenberger out to the 19-yard line. And again, Tom Gatto, he was tripped up by Whitner, I believe.
That time, anticipating pass, Perrysburg jumped back into the 5-2 defense, and still the same result.
Well, the Lake Flyers are taking their time because there is only 15 seconds, and Perrysburg going to call timeout. But we'll keep it here with just 15 seconds left in the first half. So we've had a grind amount of affair here. We had Perrysburg kicking off to Lake. Thought it might be one of those kind of games as Hackenberger broke one over the right side, got it all the way down to the 5-yard line, but Lake could not put it in. They ended up back at the Perrysburg 21. Then the two teams kind of duked it out the remainder of the first quarter until here in the second quarter, Perrysburg scored.
Perrysburg scored on a fine 53-yard quick hitter over right guard by Greg Gominger, a fine piece of running, and the kick was put through the uprights by Bill Schuf, giving us a 7-0 score. And we, prior to that, we had a succession of approximately eight punts, three by Lake and four by Perrysburg, because they've been unable to move the ball consistently.
Well, Johnston and Gominger are back deep, and Wagner is at his five to kick it. Waiting for the snap. Good snap. Return is on, and he gets a high floater away. No fair catch called for. Back here, he fumbles the football. Scramble. Who's got the hot potato? Gominger, I believe. But Johnston fumbled. Boy, he's taking chances out there, Tom. I'm not so sure. Down quickly for Lake High School was Baker. I'm not so sure that Perrysburg's head coach is real pleased about the way Johnston's handling those punts out there.
I'm sure Chuck Pratt will have a few words to lay on him at halftime.
3 seconds, two, one. That'll end the half. That's the end of the first half with the score, Perrysburg 7, Lake nothing.
Okay, at halftime, Perrysburg Yellow Jackets 7, the Lake Flyers nothing. Quite an interesting first half. The kicking game, all important. It seemed like Perrysburg had the better of the kicking game because of the field position forcing Lake to work out of deep out of their own territory. As you mentioned, Jerry, Lake got things started. They took over on their 35-yard line after a opening kickoff. Rick Hackenberger ran 55 yards down to the Perrysburg 5-yard line, first and goal.
And in the kicking game, that was also a plus for Perrysburg. Lake is going to have to get things going offensively and do a much better job in punting especially.
Oski will kick it off. Gominger is deep, along with Johnston on the near side. The ball teed in the 40-yard line here on the eastern side of the approach. And up it comes. It's going to be to Johnston at the 25, to the 30, the 35, the 36, the 37-yard line, and that is it. It'll be first down and 10 yards to go for Perrysburg at that point. Down there on the tackle for Lake High School was the man who kicked off, Oski. First and 10. Let's call it the 38-yard line of Perrysburg. They'll take over there and move right to left as Heilman will get in there to the controls. We're into the third quarter now. And Johnston out wide to the right. Out wide to the left then. Michael Jeske in a hand over the right side, hitting the 40-yard line and running hard with that football. Was Gumminger, but he was nailed right there along the line of scrimmage, and the first man to hit him for Lake High School was Larry Nicely. Gain him the play of a couple of yards out to the 40-yard line, where it will be second down and 8 yards to go. Second and about eight. Perrysburg at their own 40, and they lead in this football game by the score of 7-0. 11 minutes remaining here in the first third quarter. Out wide to the left then for the Jackets is Terrain. We have a full house in the backfield, or a power eye. And a mix-up a little bit there in the exchange. Gumminger and Heilman had a bad hookup at the 40-yard line. Gumminger was able to stumble to the 41. Big pile of humanity there. And when they unpile, the last man to get up then would be Randy Karras. Give him the 41, where it'll be third down. And about 7.5 yards to go for that first down.
Kind of an official's timeout, Jerry. It looks like Gumminger has a little dirt in his eye.
Well, he'll be administered to as the young man trots out there. Maybe he lost a contact or something.
That's possible. That misplay you mentioned, Jerry, it looked like Gumminger was trying to cut back before he got the ball. He does a fine job of running against the grain. He's going to come off and be ministered to. See who's coming in, number nine.
Reason.
Kevin Reason, a tailback, will replace Greg Gumminger. Third and seven situation here.
Johnston to the right. Michael Jeske out wide to the left. Reason is the tailback now, and back to throw the football is Heilman to run at the 40. Trying to get outside at the 45 and put down out there at about the 45-yard line, and getting out very quickly was Robson. They'll spot it at the 46-yard line, and that would bring up a fourth down.
Another Lake player down, Jerry. Looks like
84.
Dale West.
Way across the far side of the field, and let's hope it's nothing serious.
Lake certainly can't afford any more injuries.
10 minutes to go here in the third quarter. It's 7-0 Perrysburg, and they have it fourth down. About two to go. Punting situation, I would assume, here. However, the Lake Flyer is still down there on the field being looked at. Hopefully, he just perhaps had the wind knocked out of him. He gets up. And looks like he's going to be all right. I think he got a shot in the midsection. However, he's going to trot off the field. West is under his own power. Hackenberger will go deep along with Wagner if indeed Perrysburg elects to punt the football. It's at the 46-yard line. Bitter is in, replacing West, shaken up. And back to do the punting then will be Swede, Jay Swede, back at his own 32. Eckenberger on the near side, Wagner on the far side. Good snap. Return is on. He gets a pretty good kick out of there. Over the head, as a matter of fact, of Eckenberger. Wagner to the 5, to the 4, to the 3, and it is into the end zone. Just got in. I want to tell you something. Getting down there very, very quickly and almost downing that football was Johnston. However, they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line on the touchback, where it's first down and 10 yards to go now for the Lake Flyers at their own 20. And they trail 7-0 with 9:40 remaining third quarter.
This will be a key series for Lake, Jerry. Mark Patton's coming in as tailback, it looks like. Dale West is back in. And Jeff Shoup will be the other halfback. Mark Patton has been bothered by a back injury he suffered in practice. We'll see what happens here.
Well, he's in there at tailback right now. Shoup out wide to the right. And a hand into the fullback. Eckenberger to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Knocked all the way back to the 16-yard line, but he got the 20, I'm sure of that. Good heads-up hit on that one by Don Whitner. Whitner's played a heck of a football game on defense tonight for Perrysburg. They lead 7-0 with 9:21. Out of the football game is Shoup, and in is Tom McDaniels. He's a wide receiver. For Lake High School, And immediately he's deployed out wide to the right. We have an eye on the backfield. Patton is the tailback. Eichenberger is the fullback behind Wagner. And he pitches back here to Patton, trying to get outside. Got it back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And again, Whitner there to trip him up. He's all over the field tonight. 8:55 remaining third quarter, and Lake continues to try to run against this tough Perrysburg defense with not too much success since that opening play by Eichenberger.
And again, Perrysburg jumped into that 6-1 defense, Jerry, and they angled to the wide side of the field. Whitner did a fine job bringing down the tailback, Mark Patton.
Bitter is in, out McDaniels, and out wide to the right is Abbey. Now the backs are split. Patton along with Eichenberger, and Wagner is back to throw the football, rolling out to his right, looking. He's being chased. He's in trouble. He gets away from one man, unloads over the middle, and it's complete, I believe, to Abbey. Up here at the 28-yard line, that'll be a couple of yards shy of that first down, defending Thornton. Let's call it fourth and a couple of yards to go for Lake at their own 28.
Wagner did a fine job of scrambling, Jerry. Avoided two on-rushing Perrysburg linemen. Stepped up, fired a strike. But as you mentioned, it was short of the first down stake. And a good catch by Abbey in heavy traffic.
Gommager on the right side in deep safety. Johnston on the left side or the eastern side. And back to punt the football then. Waiting for the snap from center as Wagner gets the snap at the 16. Gets the kick away, angling for the sideline. Johnston up the meet. He makes the reception. Gets away from one man at the 45 and out of bounds. At about the 48-yard line, right down below us. Knocking out of bounds was Abbey, and it'll be first and 10 Perrysburg with great field position now at their own 48. 7-0 the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets. Lead it with 7 minutes and 38 seconds to go in the third quarter. And trotting out will be Jimmy Heilman with Gominger in there and Heckland.
Last time that ball was in this position, Jerry, they broke one for 53 yards.
All right. That is now Jimmy Priest running in there at split back. Priest and Gominger. Heilman calling signals, and he's back to throw the football on first down. A blitz is out. He gets away from one man, and he unloads it over here, and a man wide open, but it's overthrown. It was intended for Gominger. And putting the rush on was Hartman. A lot of steam put on also in there for, pardon me, that was Karras. Nicely put a lot of pressure that time on Heilman. Throws incomplete on first down. They get second and 10 for Perrysburg at their own 48-yard line, and they lead 7-0 with 7.5 minutes to go third quarter. Johnston to the left. High in the backfield. Heilman calling signals. It is 48. He fakes. He rolls down the line, but no, sir. Nowhere to go. Yes. Back at the 45 of Perrysburg, where it is now third down. At about 13.
Randy Karras has risen to the occasion, Jerry, from his tackle position. He and Nicely have really dominated those offensive guards and tackles in this particular half.
May have a timeout here on the field. It is for Perrysburg. Timeout on the field with a score at Perrysburg 7, Lake nothing.
Add to the success of your next party with a lavishly prepared party tray from Zenko's Old World Deli in Perry's Landing. Zenko's features a complete selection of delicious deli meats and imported cheeses, and they'll prepare a party tray for 10 or more. You'll appreciate the time it saves and the glamour that it gives to your party. Call Zenko's at 874-1401 or stop in for lunch or dinner. Zenko's makes the greatest deli sandwiches. Zenko's Old World Deli, Perry's Landing, Perrysburg, open Monday through Saturday, 10 to 7.
You're only a coin away from brighter, fresher, cleaner laundry and dry cleaning when you visit Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, 3600 Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. At Walnut Hills, they feature coin-operated laundry and dry cleaning equipment with an attendant on duty at all times. And there's always ample parking at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning. Open from 7:30 a.m. to 9 p.m. for your convenience. Just put your coins in and watch the clean come through at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio.
To work, third and 13 with the ball at the 45. We have a slot left in the backfield. Heilman calling signals, and Johnston in motion to the right. And he fakes, and he rolls down the line at the 45. And out to the 50, to the 45-yard line. And that'll be about 4 yards shy of that first down, but pretty good running by Heilman. And on the tackle, Randy Karras for Lake High. They'll spot it just outside, let's call it the 46-yard line, where it is fourth down and about four. 6:40 to go, third quarter, 7-0 Perrysburg. Wagner back, along with Hagenberger. Back to near the punting bin for Jay Swede at his own 41. Waiting for the snap. The return is on, and he gets the kick away. Good floater out of here. Hagenberger at the 7, trying to find room outside, and he's not going to do it. He's downed at about the 9. On the tackle was Kevin Reason, a quarterback. And Hagenberger gets up kind of gimpy, favoring that left ankle. Hobbles back into the huddle, but again, still checking that ankle. Trying to run it off, and here comes Shoup in. Hagenberger probably will be relieved. The ball is at the 9, and Perrysburg keeps Lake in a hole here. Lake has had very poor field position since that electrifying opening play run that got him down to the 5, but they couldn't get it in. Twin flankers out wide to the right. Wagner's your quarterback. He's got the back split. And he's back to throw. Running laterally, and he's going to be sacked into the end zone. It may be a safety. Now, let's see.
They're going to give him his forward progress, right, Jerry, at the 2-yard line.
The Lake offensive line unable to contain that forward rush by the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets, and there's a loss for the line. Back to the 3. 6-yard loss of the play. It'll be 2nd and 16, and Lake unable to move. They were going to run the option, run throw on first down, and Wagner couldn't get it done.
Again, Perrysburg jumping into that 6-man line, Jerry. Really coming. Been difficult for Lake to handle.
Coupon wide to the left. Hagenberger is in there along with Patton. They're lined up in the end zone. It goes to Patton straight ahead. He's got the 3. Good night. It'll be 3rd down. And still about 16 to go. And Whitner is in there.
Just too much penetration. Perrysburg is in there almost before the ball is snapped.
4 minutes and 59 seconds in the clock rolling here as this 3rd quarter moves right along. It's 7-0 Perrysburg. If they hold here, they should get excellent field position after the punt. Again, they line up on the I in the backfield. McDaniel's out wide to the right. And a hand to the 5, a flag on the play to the 6-yard line goes Hagenberger. But there was a flag on the play, and we'll have to wait for the call.
So the tackle was against Lake. Could be illegal procedure.
Well, Perrysburg probably will decline the penalty. Illegal procedure is the call. Lake, undoubtedly it will be declined by Perrysburg because that would bring it up. Fourth down and long.
Now that's all right, but the...
Oh, no, they're going to take the penalty down to the 2-yard line. They're going to take the penalty down to the 1-yard line.
Now that'll bring up another opportunity to force a fumble. That might not be a bad call, Jerry, or bad decision, I should say.
Should the first down occur, it would come out at about the 19-yard line, so they have it 3rd and 18 to go. 4.5 minutes remaining here in the 3rd quarter. It is 7-0 Perrysburg, and Lake getting themselves in real trouble here. Twin flankers to the right, to McDaniels and Chu. They line up in the I in the backfield with Wagner calling signals. And he gives to Hagenberger over the right side and back to the 1-yard line, and that's it. It'll be 4th down and 18 to go. And number 51, Whitner again in on the tackle. What a job he's done in that defense for Perrysburg tonight. Well, Perrysburg should get great field position here. 3:59 to go, 3rd quarter. Perrysburg leading 7-0. And now
Wagner better watch his back foot. He steps on that end line. It's a safety. It might be a better part of valor to do that, Jerry.
He's really got his work cut out. Looks like Perrysburg coming for the block. Here they come, and it's blocked. It's blocked into the end zone, and it squirts out. Now we'll have to wait for this. At number 23, Tom, I believe?
73, Jerry.
73, all right. That is Tommy Carroll.
Tommy Carroll, the linebacker.
Now, it was blocked in the end zone. It started to come out of the end zone.
It's
a safety.
The ball went out of across the sideline in the end zone.
Yes.
So it is counting as a safety.
It did not come back into the field of play. It hit the pylon at the goal line on the out-of-bounds side. That's the way we can describe it, and so it is a safety. And now a free kick will be put into effect here by Lake, either by punting or as you would do kick off to start a game. It's now 9-0 Perrysburg on the safety. And of course they're going to get the football too. 3 minutes and 39 seconds to go, third quarter, and we have a 9-0 game in favor of Perrysburg. They're undefeated going into this one. Lake had lost one, having been beaten by Anthony Wayne last Friday. And this is going to put Perrysburg, I believe, in pretty good shape, Tom, in the Northern Lakes League, because everyone else, I believe, has at least one loss, do they not?
Jerry, you put me on the spot.
I believe they do, Tom. I could be wrong on that, but I'd
rather defer.
Oh, all right.
On the grounds that it might incriminate me. Again, the kicking game, all important, as we mentioned at the top of the broadcast. You can always second-guess those things, but had that ball been recovered in the end zone, that would have been 6 points. And you almost looked for Benji Wagner to step out of bounds and get an automatic safety.
Wagner is going to free kick it as he's going to punt it. Standing back at his 15-yard line, Reason on the far side, Johnston on the near side, and Gominger at the middle of his own 35. And here is the step up and the kick, end over ender, not a real good one. Bounces around, fumbled around, booted around, and finally about three or four white shirts fall on it at the 50-yard line. And down there on the bottom for Perrysburg was Barry Johnston. So it'll be first and 10 for Perrysburg at the midfield stripe, leading 9-0 with 3.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Heilman back to work now, and he'll send Michael Jeske out wide to the left. We go back to that power backfield, that power set, and it goes to the tailback, Gominger, to the 49. And on the tackle for Lake High School, Randy Kerris. Give him a yard, it'll be 2nd and 9 at the Lake 49. 3 minutes to go, third quarter.
When they line up in that power eye, Jerry, they're almost telling you where they're going to run and say, stop us, because we're coming right at you.
That's a good way to put it, Thomas. It's at the 49. It is 2nd and 9 and out wide to the right now. We have Terran and out wide to the left. Johnston, high formation now on the backfield. Heilman calling signals. He fakes once. Little pop pass sideline left, complete to Terran, and he's down almost immediately, but not before he got it. To the 41-yard line, I believe, of Lake High School, where Wagner made the tackle. That'll be about a yard shy of that first down. That'll bring up third and about a yard.
First pass completed by Perrysburg, Jerry. Again, a look-in type pattern from Heilman to Kip Terrain, a sophomore.
Good look-in pattern, huh?
Remember the years past. That was one of the favorite passes of the Perrysburg offense.
Michael Jeske on wide to the left. Uh-oh, illegal procedure, definitely. Number 84 missed the count for Perrysburg. That was Stan Dennis, the tight end.
Tough well, penalty.
He just short. Just missed the call, or the count, I should say, and blew offside.
That's kind of like a cardinal sin for an offensive lineman.
That pushes it back out over the 45 to the 46, where it'll be third now instead of one. Third and six. That'll change it up a little bit. Into the ball game for Perrysburg comes Jay Swede.
It's been a relatively penalty-free game, Jerry.
Mm-hmm. Michael Jeske out wide to the left now, and they line up into a slot left. Johnston is the slot man. Heilman calling signals, and he's back to throw the football. Good job of faking. Sideline right at the run. Unloads downfield. Great catch! Oh, what a catch across the far side of the field. The ball was overthrown, and the youngster that made the reception may have lost his wind. No, he's all right, being helped up. That was number 81, Jay Sweet. And he went down immediately, but what a fine catch by Jay Sweet across the far sideline as the ball, I said, was thrown high. He went way up, caught it beautifully, came right down on his back, and boom.
First
Sweet
down.
Stays in.
First down for Perrysburg at the Lake 32-yard line. Second completion for Heilman. Talking about penalties, if you just tuned in, Perrysburg had a fourth down fake field goal pass nullified by a penalty in the first half.
They'll have to move the chains here now. It is a first and 10. It's at the 32 of Lake. Perrysburg leading 9-0 in a minute and 45 seconds remaining in the third quarter. There has not been all that much passing in this game tonight. However, there seems to be some delays here, Tom, tonight for injuries in in the first half. A couple of players went down. We've had some slow-ups, but not too bad. Change of quarterbacks. Change of quarterbacks. We'll pick them up in a moment. That may be Reason. Pitchback trying to sweep wide. Gumminger tacks it down to about the 31-yard line.
New quarterback, Jerry, is Joe Calabrese. All right, young man who threw that touchdown pass on the fake field goal that was nullified by the illegal receiver downfield penalty.
Gain of a yard, about second down and nine to go. On that tackle was Reyes. A minute exactly remaining third quarter. The ball is out to 31. Now Johnston out wide to the left. So Kevin... No, pardon me. That is Calabrese, the quarterback. All right, split backs. Calabrese calling signals. He's back to throw the football. Bomb, floats it in the air. Man down, Johnston. Has it, drops it. Oh! Defending on the play was Aikenberger. The ball was right on the hands to Johnson at the five, and it just flipped off his hands, and he had no chance to make a second grab. Incompleted pass, bring it back, make it 39. For Perrysburg at the 31 of Lake, with 40 seconds to go, third quarter.
Old Joe Calabrese has a fine arm, Jerry.
9-0, the Jackets lead it. Now back in is Heilman. Out wide to the left is Terrain. High in the backfield. Let's see what Heilman's going to do on a third and nine. He rolls back to runner throw. Setting up. Ducks inside. Going to run the football at the 30. Inside at the 25. Spins and down he goes. I believe for the first down.
You're right, Jerry.
Nifty bit of running on the tackle was number 74, Cannon. But Heilman with a nifty scramble got it to just about the, well, the 20-yard line. He got it by a yard.
Really got to be impressed with the running of all of these Perrysburg backs, especially in the open field. The old bag drills coming into play, Jerry. Hit the bag and roll.
Michael Deske out wide to the left. And out wide to the right goes Johnston. At the 20-yard line of Lake. Heilman calling signals, and he sticks it into Gomager at the 20. Down to about the 17-yard line. That'll probably end the quarter. And on the tackle was Todd Robeson. With that play, that is the end of the third quarter with a score. Perrysburg 9, Lake nothing.
No matter what your shopping problem, your Kazmaier Markets are eager to help you. Eager to show you how very much they appreciate your loyalty and friendship by making a visit with Kazmaier's a completely happy one. That's why the Kazmaier stock clerks are on the go every minute. They keep a watchful eye rushing in new supplies to guarantee well-filled shelves. Kazmaier personnel are never too busy to stop and help you find what you want and to give suggestions on thrifty, wonderful specials. But the most important job at Kazmaier's is to please you. That's Kazmaier's, your five-star food center in Perrysburg and Walbridge.
I lead a busy life. I work and have a family to keep up with, so I don't have a lot of time to worry about my wardrobe. I need practical, stylish clothes that reflect my lifestyle but don't break my budget. So I shop at the Fashion Closet in Perrysburg. They have just what I need. Fashions from Northern Isle, Skier, and Pure Gold. And the prices are great. I can afford to keep my wardrobe current. So if you're looking for clothes to reflect your lifestyle, shop the Fashion Closet in downtown Perrysburg. The Fashion Closet, for the active woman.
Well, Tom, we've got 12 to go in the game. At 9:30, and just a super night for football. A great crowd on hand. It's 9-0 Perrysburg, and we have it second down and four now for Perrysburg as we switch ends. Heilman in there calling signals, and he sticks it right in to his first man, right up the middle with a football. Priest, and he got it inside the fifth, well, right about the 15-yard line. That's just about it. And now the tackle was Baker. And now they're going to spot up the 14, wouldn't you know it?
That'll bring up about a third and fourth, third and three and a half, okay. Jerry. And Perrysburg has been moving the ball rather smartly from the midfield stripe to this particular point.
Heckman back in there at fullback now. Heilman calling signals, full T. Gomminger runs into his own man, bounces off, back to the middle of the gridiron, and gang tackled there. In the middle of the Lake line and on the tackle. And the very last man that gets off the bottom of the pile is Mike Baker.
Field goal attempt here, Jerry.
Watch the fake. I want to see it this time. Fourth down, still four. Trying the field goal. He'll have a straight-up shot to shoot.
It'll be about a 31-yard attempt.
Got a race ball down. Kick in the air, and it is wide to the right. Didn't get it.
Wide to right. No good.
And So the Flyers will take over, trailing 9-0 with 10:52 remaining in this football game. The Flyers are still in business, but it doesn't look to me, Tom, at least here since that opening play, and I keep going back to that because I haven't, Blake, had a real great play since that opening run by Eichenberger.
Now their offense is really hurting with the absence of Mark Patton, the fine tailback, for most of the first half. He's in there now at tailback with Eichenberger at full.
All right, at the 20-yard line then, Lake moving right to left on your dial and rolling out to his right to run, pitch back to Patton, and Patton turns the corner across the far side and got about 5-6 yards on the play. Way across the far side of the east or western side is Stan Dennis to nail him down. Let's see where they bring it in. They're going to say the about 26. He got about 6 on it. It'll be second down and about 4 to go. Make it 5. Second and 5 with 10:39 remaining here in the football game. 9-0 Perrysburg. They're in the I formation. Wagner's your quarterback. Open field is to the eastern side. He rolls to the short side. Going to keep the football? No, he pitches again to Patton, and Patton is gang tackled. Way across the far side of the western side again. And let's give credit to Whitner, number 51.
Again, the load option to the short side of the field, Jerry. The quarterback sprinting down the line of scrimmage was forced deep.
Tom, he actually lost about a yard on that play.
Well,
really?
I can understand why, because the Perrysburg perimeter forced the pitch man back and also forced the quarterback deep into the backfield.
So the ball would be spotted then at the 24. In the backfield. Back to throw Wagner. Over the middle it goes, but it's incomplete to Patton. Patton had some daylight ahead of him, but the ball was underthrown.
Running out of the T-bone that time, Jerry. Patton slipped out of the backfield, and as you mentioned, was wide open, but the pass was underthrown, forcing Lake to punt again.
Stops the clock with 9:52 to go on the ball game. It is 9-0 Perrysburg, and Lake's going to give up pretty good field position here again, I believe. Gominger and Johnston back deep. It'll be Wagner back to do the punting, standing at his 14. Let's see if the return is on or the block. 9-0 Perrysburg. Waiting for the snap. Now there it is. The return is on. And he gets the kick away. Pretty good kick out of there this time. Good hang time. Johnston back at the 45. Running laterally at the 50. Get a wall. 45, 40, 35 at the 30. At the 25 at the 20. At the 15. One man to beat. 5-4-3. Touchdown.
55 yards on that return, Jerry, by Gary Johnston.
You can see the wall form here on the eastern side, Tom.
And you can also understand, I think, why Barry Johnson has caught punts this evening with reckless abandon. He's really been looking for that long gainer on punt return.
You know, I was just going to mention that. Earlier in the ball game, we mentioned the fact that Johnston had fumbled a couple back there and looked a little shaky, but obviously that's the reason why Platts allows him to field, because he's a threat to break it all the way. Waiting for the kick, ball in the air, and the kick is good. The kick is good. Lake, nothing. Beautiful bathrooms begin at the Color Bathhouse in Perrysburg. Color. You know, there's a we need to run our cars, homes, businesses, and farms. Lorraine Oil represents the Sun Oil Company, Pennzoil, and Quaker State, and their fleet of trucks and tankers guarantee prompt delivery. Discuss your petroleum needs with Lorraine Oil President Mr. Bernie Schneider. Call Lorraine Oil at 691-3545 or 352-1633. Well, Tom, that was a super punt return. You can see the wall set up just like you diagram it. Just kickoff, a line drive affair, bobbled around, picked up by Wagner at the 10, 15, 20, 25. Oh, he's splattered. Out at about the 25 or 6-yard line.
Again, you can't emphasize the kicking game enough, Jerry. And certainly Perrysburg is well coached in that area, because punt returns are part of that kicking game.
Yes, so Tom, we talk about that kicking game so often, and most folks will be talking about field goals, extra point, kickoff. We're talking about the entire kickoff game, the run backs, the fielding of punts, etc.
T-Bone again.
T-Bone. Jerry. All right. Wagner will put it in the air. He's back to throw at the 15. Out it comes, and it's complete out here to Patton Upfield at the 35, at the 40, and all the way out to the 45 or 6, 7-yard line. Let's see where he stepped out of bounds, around the 47. Defending on the play was Johnston.
That time, Jerry, Benji Wagner got the pass up. Fine play with Mark Patton coming out of the backfield. He was contesting with a linebacker there for the ball, but he came up the winner and a first down for Lake High School.
Well, the ball is at the 47. Twins to the left now. McDaniels and Abbey. The backs are split. Wagner calling signals at his own 47. He options down the line, pitches back to Patton. He's in trouble, and he's brought down on a nice open field tackle across the far side. That's probably
Gominger,
and it is.
Gominger, the stinger back or monster, goes to the wide side and came up in a hitting position across the line of scrimmage and took on Mark Patton, dropped him in his tracks.
A yard loss at the 40, maybe 2-yard loss. Let's call it the 45 of Lake, where it is second and 12. Abbey out wide to the right. The ends are in. Splitbacks are the order of this play. Wagner with open field to the east, and he rolls back as he fakes in there, and he's in trouble. He's going to be sacked by Whitner back inside the 35 at about the 34-yard line.
Lake again, Lake offensive line cannot handle that 6-1 set, defensive set of Perrysburg. They jumped into it again, filled the gaps, and were in on Benji Wagner before he had a chance to look downfield for a receiver.
Call up the 35-yard line, where it is third and about 21, and the clock moves. With 7:50 left in the game, it's 16-0 in favor of Perrysburg, and the Jackets are going to remain in first place by themselves. They look very, very good here tonight. McDaniels out wide to the left, and now there's a mix-up in the backfield, and Lake wants a timeout. Timeout on the field with the score, Perrysburg 16, Lake nothing.
You're only a coin away from brighter, fresher, cleaner laundry and dry cleaning when you visit Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, 3600 Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. At Walnut Hills, they feature coin-operated laundry and dry cleaning equipment with an attendant on duty at all times. And there's always ample parking at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning. Open from 7:30 a.m. to 9 p.m. for your convenience. Just put your coins in and watch the clean come through at Walnut Hills Laundry and Dry Cleaning, Drouillard Road in Walbridge, Ohio. Racquetball. The Racquet Connection in Perrysburg offers you all this. 12 racquetball courts, plus indoor tennis courts, a heated indoor pool, exercise equipment, lounge areas, saunas and whirlpools, a pro shop, nursery, and a family Nautilus Center. The Racquet Connection in Perrysburg. Play racquetball, tennis, and swim all year round. Join now for fall and winter fun. The Racquet Connection, 874-4318. 874-4318, near the Holiday Inn in Perrysburg.
Remind you, Ed Burns around with some time, perhaps, with a little music. Our football scoreboards, 10:05, 11:05 this evening on Friday nights. We'll run them down for you. Don't forget to give us a call. If you've got that final score, help us out. Give Ed Burns a call. We'd like to get him on for you. Back to throw the football on third down. Unloads it deep down the left sideline, and it's almost intercepted. The nearest man to it was the safety,
Dave Stanford.
Stanford for Perrysburg. The ball was overthrown by Wagner. That stops the clock with 7:32 remaining in the fourth quarter. 16-0, the Jackets lead.
A little breakdown in the pattern run by the Lake receiver, Jerry.
Well, again, some injuries, certainly to Patton of Lake, hurt their offensive cause tonight. But as coaches will tell you, you have to play over the injuries. But I just don't know. Over the years, Tom, unless you're an Ohio State or Notre Dame or Nebraska or Oklahoma, they look like clones out there a lot of times, those teams. Good high kick by Wagner. No fair catch. No, he did call for a fair catch, Johnston. And there goes the 9:40 limited, I think, right behind the press box here. Shaking and baking a little bit up here in the press box.
That's a Wabash cannonball.
Is that what it is? Well, that's the 50, the 45, that's the 40-yard line, Tom, of Perrysburg, where they'll take over. Do, 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 do. We've got it. First and 10 for Perrysburg at their own 40, and they lead 16-0 in the power eye. A pitch back here to Gominger at the 40, straight ahead of the 44-yard line, and he's wrapped up right there in a good tackle by Randy Kerris. But on the pickup, about 5 yards on the play, it'll be second down, and five to go for Perrysburg at their own 45, moving left to right on your dial, or south to north. We're on the eastern side, 6:59 remaining in the game, and out wide to the right is Michael Juski. Again, a slot ride, and in motion is Johnston to the left. And a pitch back here to Gominger, trying to turn it inside, and oh, he is hit and brought down, and a fine, fine hit that time by Larry Nicely. He hit Gominger head up, right up around those numbers, and drove him back about 3 yards. They'll give him his penetration to the line of scrimmage, where it is third and five. Well, I'll tell you, Lake still socking away out there. They're still playing.
That time, Jerry Gominger cut it back a little too soon. He had enough interference to take it wide, but he tried to cut back, and Lake was waiting for him.
Again, Michael Juski out wide to the left, Johnston out wide to the right. Eye on the backfield, Heilman Conan signals, and he sticks. No, he's back to throw. Over the middle it goes, and it's complete up ahead of the 50 at the 45-yard line. That's probably Johnston.
That was Michael
Juski.
It's a play-by-play caller's dream to have a young man by the name of Michael Olszewski.
Abby on the tackle. It's first and 10 for the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets. Now in the Lake territory at the 44-yard line, and Johnston to the left. And out wide here to the right is Kip Terrain. Splitbacks. Dive over the left side, just a straight ahead. Dive play. Running the football was Eklund, and he was hit after a gain of 2 or 3 yards in the play. Nicely on the tackle. They're going to spot the football at the 42. Give them about 3. It'll be 2nd and 7 with 5:30 left in the game. Perrysburg not getting real fancy here right now. Michael Juski out wide to the right. Johnson out wide to the left. And again, Heilman calling. He's back to throw the football. Going down the right sideline. He's got a complete out here to Michael Juski. He tries to get away from Wagner, but he's ducked down by the shirt. And about the 37-yard line, that'll be shy of the first down. Make it maybe the 36.
That time, Lake defenders were right there to put Mark Michael Olszewski down. No receiver had driven any of the defensive backs deep. He went under some of that coverage and picked up about 5 yards.
Gottfried is in now at a wide receiver to the right. Deployed out wide to the left, Michael Juski. The backs are split. A handoff dive to Gominger over the right side, and I think he's a little short of that first down. Knifing in there and lowering the boom was Reyes. It's outside the 35. The initial line there was the 36. He got it maybe to the 35-and-a-half-yard line. That'll bring up fourth and a long yard. 4 minutes to go in the game. 16-0. The Perrysburg Yellow Jackets will remain undefeated in the Northern Lakes League, marching to Peoria as they continue their drive for another NLL championship.
Peoria?
Or marching back to Perrysburg, if you will. Split backs. Johnson to the left. Back to throw the football, Heilman. He's going deep, but Johnson on the fly, and it is complete at the 10, at the 5, at the 4. It's a touchdown!
Well, that's one for the books.
How about that, Tom? I thought they might just, sock it in there. Not get too fancy, and Heilman goes back, and he threads it down the far sidelines on the takeoff of the fly pattern by Johnston, who made the reception around the 10-yard line over Eckenberger, the defender, and went in for the score. Ball down, kick of the air, the kick is good. There's a timeout on the field with a score. Perrysburg 23, Lake nothing.
Add to the success of your next party with a lavishly prepared party tray from Zenko's Old World Deli in Perry's Landing. Zenko's features a complete selection of delicious deli meats and imported cheeses, and they'll prepare a party tray for 10 or more. You'll appreciate the time it saves and the glamour that it gives to your party. Call Zenko's at 874-1401 or stop in for lunch or dinner. Zenko's makes the greatest deli sandwiches. Zenko's Old World Deli, Perry's Landing, Perrysburg, open Monday through Saturday, 10 to 7.
Jerry, Perrysburg crossed everybody up. Fourth and one, going up top for all the marbles. A 34-yard touchdown pass from Jim Heilman to Barry Johnston.
Well, you know, the last two or three years, Perrysburg High School has got it all together. Not only educationally, as all the institutions do, but certainly athletically. They have really put it together in all sports, Tom. Football, basketball,
not only that,
soccer,
the
volleyball,
the girls' sports at Perrysburg,
yes,
are well coached,
yes,
and had a lot of success. And
they look sharp tonight.
Lake High School has been no slouch in the last couple of years as well. Fine leadership.
Good high end over end kickoff. Aikenberger at the 7 to the 10, 15, 20. 25-yard line, and the boom is lowered right there by Stevie Morgan. First and 10.
That'll be at the 20, Jerry.
20? All right. Little tough when they knock down those sideline markers over there. They kind of kick them around and boot them around, and so you just kind of hunt and peck and kind of pick one out that's still standing and go from there.
That's where they used to do it in the old days, right, Jer?
Yeah. Try to confuse the officials. 3 minutes and 37 seconds remaining in the game. 23 to nothing in favor of Perrysburg. The Lake Flyers have hung in. They've given it their all. But it just hasn't quite been enough here tonight, Tom. After, for those folks who may have just joined it, a first play scrimmage after Lake had taken the kickoff, and Aikenberger with a brilliant run down to the 5. First and goal, Lake at the 5, only to end up back on their own around the Perrysburg 21.
That was kind of like a harbinger of doom,
yeah,
for Lake at that time.
They kind of duked it around the rest of the first quarter, back and forth, kind of jockeying for field position. The punting game, I think, finally got Perrysburg good field position into the second quarter. And from that point, Pieberg was able to punch one in. It wasn't really much of a punch. It was a big play run by Gominger to go 7-0 at halftime. And here in the second half, it's been pretty much all Perrysburg. But again, the Flyers have
Never stopped playing, Tom. Perrysburg had a touchdown called back, so the score could be even higher.
Ed Byrne standing by with scores from around the area. Don't forget to give us a call if your game is over by now. 240-1370-1370, the call letter frequency, 1370-240. All right, back to work. Wagner, hands in there to the first man. He got him back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And running the football was Abbey. It's right there at the 20-yard line where it is second down and 10. And Lake continues, for the most part, to stay on the ground here.
There for Lake. Second team offense, for the most part, getting a chance to get some action here.
That is still Wagner in there at quarterback, however. At his own 20-yard line, he splits his setbacks, and we'll get the youngsters in a moment. He rolls to his left to run or throw the football. A man is open, but he's going to run it. 25, 30, down the near sidelines and out of bounds, up around the 35-yard line. Ridden out of bounds was Dave Cozier, a tight end, playing a little defense here. Now, I said 35. He'll have to be patient with the old broadcaster here. I lost the yard marker. That's the 29-yard line, so it's third and about a yard. Oh, my. Well, we'll get those hash marks and those permanent fixtures out there at the Glass Bowl tomorrow night. That's no knock against the folks here at Lake High School. It happens every Friday night in high school football. It's kind of tough. But like coaches, we won't alibi. Back to throw the football. Wagner rolls out, unloads over the middle. It is underthrown. Did he make the catch or not? Or did he trap it? The official says he trapped the football. He being bitter. Bring it back. 2 minutes and 47 seconds left in the game. 23 to nothing in favor of Perrysburg. It is now fourth down and still about a yard, yard and a half to go. Well, Thomas, tomorrow night we'll be at the Glass Bowl for Toledo and Eastern. And And tomorrow afternoon, I suppose you'll be playing golf, or will it be a little too cold for you?
No, Jerry, I'll probably be mowing.
Going to mow the back 40, huh? Wagner back at his own 15. Johnston far side. They're going to fake it. Wagner going to unload it. It's intercepted. It's intercepted by Calabrese at the 30, at the 25, down to about the 20-yard line. Well, Perrysburg was not fooled at all. They elected to go for the option kick pass, and Wagner decided to pass the football, and only he passed it right into the hands of Joe Calabrese, a quarterback.
Well, Joe Calabrese came from his short side halfback position, read the pass well, stepped in front of the intended receiver, and tried to cut back against the grain, go all the way, but he was stopped.
That's the 20-yard line. Heilman is still in there at quarterback. He's going back past football. Unloads it. It's complete to Michael Jeske at the 15-yard line. Hit immediately by Abbey. Well, they're going right back to work here.
Perrysburg has a man down over here, right, Jerry.
Only thing here, you're leading 23-0 with 2:05 left in the game, Tom. You know, there's next year.
Well, I don't understand the rationale, but...
Well, perhaps they just want to work on their passing game. I don't know what else the reason would be why Perrysburg continues to put it up.
Well, they're starting to substitute freely here, they being Perrysburg. Kevin Reason is in the game. Gominger is out.
I'm not sure. Oh, they lost a contact.
Yeah, that's the old look for the contact trick.
Oh, my. This is like looking for a needle in a haystack. It's bad enough trying to find a contact on a basketball floor, but out here in natural turf, I think you might have to have the old magnifying glass and then some.
Almost like looking for hen's teeth.
Maybe Rick can zero in with his camera. And he's got one of those infrared jobs or something. He can put on the lens and zero in on it and try to pick it out down there. Maybe he found it. That was Priest in there.
Now we got some new folks in there for Perrysburg, Jerry. Let's see if we can pick them up.
Rick decides that's not a real big play action for television, so he puts it back on his shoulder, the camera that is, and back to work we go. Heilman, pitch back, trying to skirt the corner and out of the five, and trying to carry him in is Reason, and he carried a man with him, another leg flyer down here at the 10. And Wagner finally brought him down. That was a tailback sweep to the eastern sideline down to the 3.
If there's one play you can count on Perrysburg running a great deal during a ball game, is that power sweep, and they run it so very well, and that time they almost picked up 6 with it.
Well, Heilman's still in there, number 45 and 9 in there. That's Reason. 45.
Eklund.
Eklund is the fullback. First and goal at the 3. It goes to Reason, the tailback, down at the 3. Good defensive play.
Now, Calabrese is in at quarterback, Jerry.
All right. I'll try to keep up with it here as they keep putting new players in and out for us. It's a minute. Let's see. All right, a minute and 30 seconds to go here.
Terry Roush now, a third-team quarterback, is in for Perrysburg, number 7.
Well, there goes the 9:55.
Don't you hear the whistle, the rumble, and the
Well, that thing almost sounds like it's going to come through the press box.
Yeah, have to hang on.
How close are those railroad tracks?
Too close. It's almost as close as the railroad tracks to Grandma's kitchen in Swanton.
Is that right?
Every time it goes by, you have to hang on to your plate, lose your egg.
1:29 left of the game. 23-0 Perrysburg, and they're knocking at the door again. Your quarterback now is number 7. That's Roush. High formation. Reason. Oh, almost fumbled. Oh, he's hit hard. Down to about the 4. He almost fumbled the ball back here at the 6. Securing the tackle for Lake was nicely. 1 minute to go as the clock continues to run.
Well, the Lake defense does not want insult added to injury here. They are fighting mad. They all want
They're still playing.
Perrysburg to get into that end zone.
They're still playing. Roush is the quarterback. We'll wrap it up here quickly for you. Power eye in the backfield. almost illegal procedure. Roush options down the line, pitches back, throws the ball in the air, and it's incomplete. It was intended for the tight end, number 83. That's Thornton. Stops the clock with exactly 40 seconds remaining here in the football game. 23-0, Perrysburg leading Lake. They'll retain first place in the Northern Lakes League unscathed as we're at about the halfway mark.
Well, I like that word.
Here's the field goal by Schuf. The attempt, anyway.
A long way, Jerry.
Snap, kick in the air. He's got the distance. Does he have the direction?
Yep.
It is good. And we'll kick it here. Well, we've kicked a couple here tonight. We'll keep it here and tell you the score is now 26-0 in favor of Perrysburg. And I want to thank at this time our sponsors on the broadcast tonight for being with us again on our WSPD High School Sports Extra. We appreciate it. Always good to have them. Supporting their local community and their local high school.
26-0.
We'll check things out for you on Monday, and perhaps we'll be prowling the area again next Friday. We'll see what it looks like, what the matchups are.
I wonder if our entourage will be with us.
I don't know. Maybe I better check with them and see where they're going to go. 26-0 in favor of Perrysburg with only 35 seconds remaining. Shoot the kickoff for the Jackets, the Yellow Jackets, and a high kick, but not too deep. Coming up to meet it. Stahari fumbles the football for a moment in midair, then gets it back, and running with the football is Shoop, and he is hit and brought down along the sidelines about the 26. 30 seconds remaining. WSPD Toledo 1370 on your dial, your station for sports. Jerry Kyle, Tom Gatone will be with you again tomorrow night at Glass Bowl Stadium. It all begins at 6:55 on WSPD with our pregame programming and kickoff at 7:30. But better yet, we hope to see you at the Glass Bowl tomorrow night. Let's fill her up again, fans. The Rockets are smarting just a bit. I got a feeling they're going to let it all
hang out
tomorrow night. Go for broke. Do we have a new quarterback for Lake? I think we may. I want to give the youngster some credit here at the 25-yard line. That's number 12, and he fumbles the football and recovers. Well, that's going to happen. It's Brad Carr. He's just a sophomore, 5'6", 140-pounder. The son of Mr. and Mrs. Neil Carr. 16 seconds with 15 on the clock continues to roll, and that may just about do it here. And Tom will wrap it up very quickly. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, 5 seconds. Carr pitches back and trying to turn the corner here for Lake High. Wouldn't you know it? Don't have his number. He's brought down, however, at the 27-yard line. And with that play, that'll end the football game here at Lake High School. Tom, very quickly, how about just a brief synopsis on your part of this one tonight?
Well, quite honestly, Jerry, Lake High School was outmanned, not outplayed, but outmanned when it came to the offensive side of the ledger. Perrysburg, a little tough going in the first half for them. They only got 7 points on the board, had one called back, but the kicking game was so all important, as Perrysburg had the upper hand there. Got their offense rolling in the second half, some fine defensive play by Perrysburg as well, and they continue undefeated, 5-0, also undefeated in the NLL. Perrysburg in first place. Lake drops to 3-2 on the season.
Tom, I want to thank you. Excellent job as always. The old ex-coach analyzing our football game for us tonight. And we'll see you again tomorrow night at Glass Bowl Stadium.
Okay, certainly will.
Okay, bud. That'll about do it. Then we thank all the folks here at Lake High School for making our stay so pleasant this evening, as always, and to all the high schools in the area. Very, very happy to have brought you these games throughout the many, many years. With that, Jerry Kyle for Tom Cattell from Lake High School saying then, the final score in this one tonight, the Perrysburg Yellow Jackets, 26, the Lake Flyers, nothing. So long, everybody.
You are a promise. You are a possibility. You are a promise. You're a promise. A promise with a capital P. You're a great big bundle, a great big bundle of potentiality. You are a promise. You are a possibility. You are a promise with a capital P. You are a great big bundle of potentiality. And if you listen, you will hear God's voice. And if